3, 2, 1.
I don't have no words right now. Welcome to the Hey, welcome to the NoMoreDirty TV show. This dude right here, man. Listen, you messed me up for real. Listen, but I'm gonna go with this show because we talk about comedy. Part two, baby. Why comedy, man? Why do we need comedy in our life? Listen, I'm your host, the comedian today. Dude, this sounded good. Okay, all right, let me get my life together. Woosa. So I'm your host, Fred Whitlow II, aka Minister Fred II. I'm here with the crazy cuckoo for Cocoa Puff, part two. Here's my man, Kenny Green. Oh my gosh, from Green Room Entertainment. We're here to entertain you today. Listen, we're going to talk about some more comedy. Listen, but this time, we're going to talk about why clean comedy, right? Like, we talked about last week about enjoying the comedy and enjoying comic relief. But I want to kind of give you some little things to think about as you peruse the lanes of comedy, right? So again, don't forget, now this coming Saturday, listen, this is literally a day away. Literally, March 9th. Oh, you might be catching this on the replay. But March 9th, Saturday, March 9th is what we're talking about, folks. Right here, the studio is ready. You just don't see all of the good stuff here. We got it, it's really nice up in here. We're transforming this studio, 3,000 square foot space, into a clean comedy building. And we're gonna have the amazing clean comedian, that is Double D. So anyway, I'm gonna get in, we're gonna have some good times, we're gonna have a great time, we're gonna laugh, we're gonna giggle together, because we were giggling at the beginning of the show, no, my apologies. But that dude, man, Kenny is not right, man. Kenny ain't right, man. The green ain't right today. It ain't right. So anyway, let's get this thing started. We're going to go with Zach, man. Zach Rose got a song called Holy. At some point, you got to be holy. Because if not, you're unholy. And then we're going to give you some. Another comedian, Miss Johnson. She going to flip your wig with, like, you know, Christian hip hop and rappers be like. We'll be right back. Kitty's listening. We'll be right back. Oh, snap.
Romans 12, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. Amen.
Lord, I am weak, but in you I am strong. I know you see beneath these wings beats a heart of stone. I know I need to hit my knees, cause I've been struggling for weeks. Feel like I'm melting in this heat, but I keep pressing on. I'm to that point, I'm sick of the lifestyle that I'm living in. And I know the truth, and the truth is you, so Lord, I'm giving in. And Lord, I really need your help, cause it's affecting all of my health. You can do it by yourself, so I ain't pitching in. Empty me, then fill me up again and make me whole. The suicide, pride, and depression, yeah, it's got to go. The cares and worries of this world about to take their toll. Ripping what I sow, how much further can my shoulders go? I don't know, deep in your presence I can truly rest. I'm so impressed with you, Lord, I am truly blessed. And I can say there was a time that I would not agree. But Father God, I'm so thankful that you water seed just for me.
Lord, I am weak, but in you I am strong. Cause it's in you I know that I belong. Come live in me and make my heart your home. Take this heart of stone, I know I'm not alone. Up on that cross you made a sacrifice. No other man could ever pay that price. You gave your life, so I'm gonna give you mine. Only you are right on time. I'm holy and you are divine. And now I'm singing holy, holy. I'ma keep singing holy. I'm singing holy, holy, I'ma keep singing holy.
Hallelujah.
I'm singing holy, holy, I'ma keep singing holy. I'm singing holy, holy, I'ma keep singing holy. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I can see now that you saved me. Had your hands on me ever since I was a baby. That boy gone and he crazy, ain't no hope left for him. Put him in the potter's hands, no one except for him. See, I ain't out here trying to gain fame and the following. Trying to be a Paul, not a Jonah boy. The mission field is swallowing.
find some Jesus. When I'm dead and gone and you think of me, I don't even want you to think of me. This ministry that he's giving me is lifting him up and it's sinking me. I don't need a platform and a merch line. Got his Holy Spirit living up in me. When I show up, it's church time. He shows up at the worst time. Nah, I know it's how it seems. But he's on time every single time. And it's showtime, no fees.
Oh, I am weak, but in you I am strong. Cause it's in you I know that I belong. Come live in me and make my heart your home. Take this heart of stone, I know I'm not alone.
Come inside,
up on that cross you made a sacrifice. No other man could ever pay that price. You gave your life so I'm gonna give you mine. Only you are right on time. Holy and you are divine. And now I'm singing holy, holy. I'ma keep singing holy. I'm singing holy, holy. I'ma keep singing holy.
Hallelujah.
I'm singing holy, holy. I'ma keep singing holy. I'm singing holy, holy. I'ma keep singing holy.
I want you to understand today that the way to become a living sacrifice is to come to God dead to your flesh, dead to yourself, dead to your agenda, dead to your own ideas of your future. Come completely dead to self, and that's when you begin to live the kind of life that hell doesn't know how to stop and what to do with. When you come to God, you do not hold God out a contract and say, these are my stipulations for following you. You hold out a blank sheet of paper with your name signed in covenant at the bottom, and you say, this is for you to fill out. This life is not my own. I'm not here because of how smart I am or how genius I am or how connected I am. I'm here because of grace, by grace, through grace, because of mercy. I wasn't even supposed to make it this long, and whatever you want me to do, that is what living sacrifice is all about.
And people ask me, like, who's your husband? Who is this guy? Tell us about him, right? Well, it's actually kind of funny because I used to do a joke on my first DVD where I talked about Christian rap music and Christian rappers. How, like, it's so cheesy. Like, what are you going to do, bust a cap in the devil? Like, what? Right? Like, what's your name? Ludacris? Coming to the stage, Jay Zeezus. What's up? Right? Like, so cheesy. So, of course, the person I'd end up marrying is a Christian rapper. Yeah, joke's on me. Oh, you're funny, Jesus. When we first started dating, I was kind of embarrassed to tell my friends and my family because, like, I knew I had the joke. I knew they knew I had the joke. So I was just trying to avoid it. Like, my cousin Joe, he's like, who is this guy? What does he do? I was like, he's in a band. Cool, what does he play? Play. I don't really know if he's athletic or not. No, instrument. Oh, you said play, that can mean like 20 things. he plays the lyricist. Yeah, it's new, you probably never heard of that one.
Man, this dude is out of control. I told y'all, man, this is a show to be had. So listen, welcome back. It's a No More Dirty TV show, second edition, comic relief with Kitty and I. Listen, I told you that was gonna be good. Didn't you think, did you like, oh girl, she's funny. She like Christian rappers be like, okay. So to flip the script, let me give you a script. We're going to go with this one right now. It says, Proverbs 19:11 says, good sense makes one slow to anger. And it is his or her glory that's overlooked by the offense. When you're laughing, what I've learned and you will discover is that laughter helps you move through a situation. Hear me. Okay, case in point, example. I'm mad. I'm straight mad. Bruh, I'm mad. And then somebody just comes in and says, hey man, at the random, and you start, what was that about? You totally forget how mad you are or were. So again, humor has a way of snatching the bad, snatching the hurt, transposing pain into funny bones. All right, so we gotta give you our featured artist for the day. I had to give you that one because we've been talking off the offside that this dude is out of control. He does not need to do anything else today. So listen, we're going to go with my man. Hey, you know what, Kenny, let's do this comedian. I think we're going to do John Chris. You know, John Chris, he go live, man. But he got a script, a little short snippet, and it's called Bad Kids with Bible Names. Don't give your kid a Bible name and he's a hellion. Jesus is like, oh my God. We'll be right back. You made a mistake. Tell Jesus, don't do that again. We got to go, man. Woo! Get me out of here.
Because kids these days, like every kid in my family, very Christian family, every kid is a name from the Bible. Everyone has a Bible name in our family. Anybody got a Bible name up here in the front? What you got, man?
Samuel,
what did he do? You don't know. Didn't listen, I'll tell you that. Anybody else got one? What you got, man?
Mary.
Okay, yeah. Thanks for coming. I got nothing for that. My name's John. This is a true story. I asked my mom, why'd you name me John? They said, we named you after John the Baptist. I go, me? I don't think I'm doing a very good job. John the Baptist, dude, this man baptized Christ, was martyred for his faith. I used to coupon at Wendy's yesterday. Like, just stop naming your kids Bible names. It's not helping. It's not lying. My nephew is named Malachi. His name is Malachi. Malachi in the Bible, this man was a warrior, prophet, strong. My nephew Malachi, extreme peanut allergy. Just... Malachi in the Bible, this man hunted for his own food. This kid wears a teething necklace. Mm. It's embarrassing. No, my sister would be like, oh, he's reading about Malachi, reading the story of Malachi. One day when you get to heaven, you're going to meet the real Malachi. The real Malachi is going to be embarrassed. You're bad for the brand, dude, you know? Kids are naming the kids Bible names. They're not even good kids. You've seen these? Here's our son, Paul. I've seen that kid. That's Saul. Dude, that's a bad... The name should line up. That's all I'm saying. The name should line up. I got a buddy named Caleb. His name is Caleb. Just like, I know. It's like, Caleb in the Bible, this man was a warrior, led the children of Israel into battle, took the land of milk and honey. My buddy Caleb, allergic to milk and honey. Just... You guys have been fantastic. My name is John Chris. Thank you.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back to the Comic Relief. And this is clean comedy, no more dirty style. I'm your host, what's my name? The Minister Fred, too. Listen, I was thinking about this one here. Why clean comedy, right? And I want to read a scripture, and I want to give you, this is funny, it's a breakdown. We're going to do something contemporary. John 9, chapter 9, 17 through 21. And so they said to the blind man, what are you saying to him? Jesus ain't got time for you. And then the Jews didn't believe him anyway. And Jesus was like, hey, bro, stop. Think about Jesus pulling up on somebody like, man, why y'all stop fooling with my man? And then heal somebody in front of him. Boy, I bet somebody was laughing. I bet somebody was like, oh, did you see that, puppy? Did you see that, bro? John! You know, one of the things about humor is you can take humor and teach a lesson. Jesus taught lessons through parables and through funny moments. Remember Lazarus? Lazarus dead for 4 days, right? And this is what's funny. 4 days, Jesus didn't show up. Martha and Mary are really upset with Jesus. And then Mary says, and Mom says, well, if you would have been here, he wouldn't have died. Jesus hits them with a funny moment. He says, I get it. But just so you can believe, he just sleep. What? wait. Jesus is dead. I mean, Lazarus is dead, excuse me. Jesus pulls up 4 days later. His body is stinking, is deteriorating. And you say he just sleep? That's a funny moment. Meanwhile, he said, just roll the stone away. He calls Lazarus by name. This dude come out shining like bling bling. What a moment. It was a hilarious moment, but it was a teaching lesson. What humor does is teaches us through the worst of our pains Richard Pryor says it best. Eddie Murphy did it with Delirious. All the craziness, you know, Richard Pryor burning himself, somebody throwing hot grease on you, and he like, you laughing, but that person was actually burning, but you found some humor in the moment. So listen, let's go to, I want to go to this guy, Kenny. Let's do, he's one of my favorite clean comedians. It is Marcus Wiley. Let's do Marcus Wiley, Kenny. Then let's give him the boom bap with Dante with being relatable, because comedy is always relatable. So check it out. Enjoy these two joints. Get you a little laugh. Get you a little boom bap. Come on back and let's laugh together again. We'll be right back.
Good morning, Concord. My name is Marcus D. Wiley. Hey, TSU, what's up? Okay. What's up? Man, I tell you, now this 10 o'clock, y'all a little lively. 8 o'clock, you know, it's a little different. So is this like this is a mixture church and a club crowd? I mean, no shade, because, you know, both institutions, you know, they create some of the same dynamics, you know. You got people who hang out at church like it's a club. Then you got folks who go to the club religiously. Yeah. You know, man, I could tell you, just take on a little journey. Like, you go to the club, they got a thing called bouncers. Bouncers are there to maintain order. Make sure you don't sneak in without paying. You go over to the church, got a thing called ushers. They here to maintain order. Make sure you don't sneak out without paying your tithes and your off. Close the door, it's offering time, lock them. You go to the church, to the club have a bartender. Bartender ushers out spirits. Go to the church have a praise team leader or a pastor, ushers in the spirit. Yeah. Men try to get with women at the club. Ladies, you don't like it because a brother don't know your name, so he got to reference something you wearing to get your attention. So he got to be like, red. Psst, Gucci purse. Hold up, Gucci purse. Psst, say little PT, little ponytail. What's up? Holla at your boy. Men try to get with women at church, too. They just make more of a spiritual reference. They be more like, virtuous. Psst, something like Mary. What's up? Psst, answer to my prayers. Ah, girl, you must be my rib. Believe it or not, you got people who go to the club, they don't drink, they don't smoke, they don't dance, they don't do nothing. They just like being there. Believe it or not, you got people who come to church. They're not in ministry. They don't participate. They don't give. They don't do nothing. They just like being here. But y'all, I'm one of them Christians, what you call, I'm free. Everybody say free. Free. I came from a church where they said, any way you bless me, Lord, I'll be satisfied. And I took that and ran with it, right? Because 8 years ago, my wife came up to me. She was like, babe, I'm pregnant, and it's yours. I was like, all right, put that on me. Okay. But we ain't know nothing about having kids. And I was at the barbershop, and a dude came up to me. He said, say, bro, I hear you about to have a baby. I was like, nah, my wife here. But it's like the same thing. He's like, well, you know, I work at the hospital. I was like, you the doctor? He's like, nah, I work at the hospital, and I get stuff. It's like, you get stuff? He's like, yeah, you're going to need Pampers. You're going to need milk. I work at the hospital, and I get stuff. I was like, oh, okay, yeah, how much? He said, give me $100. Concord Church, in my garage, stacked from the floor to the ceiling, were boxes of diapers and milk. Here's where I went wrong. One Sunday after church, I took one of these other Christians that's not free home with me. We go through the garage. He see all the boxes. He like, man, what's all these boxes? I said, pimp that's milk and diapers. He said, man, I bet you spent an arm and a leg on all that. I said, $100. Dude at the barbershop hooked me up. Here he go, boy, that's stealing. That man stole that stuff, and you got your baby drinking this stolen milk. Your baby could drink this milk and die. He gonna kill my baby. But that's how they act when they not getting blessed. Something always wrong with your blessing. And them type of Christians don't even read the Bible, because somewhere in there it say the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. And I'm just trying to see how you gonna get the wicked's wealth if you don't know nobody wicked. Some of y'all praying for a flat screen, you better go to the barbershop. All right, y'all. Y'all good?
Hopefully we can find a place to chat. We can find a place to chat. Let's keep it real, I've been exactly where you at. So when we speak, it's with some mutual respect. I understand a lot of people can't relate. So when they speak, they try to put you in your place. But that ain't me, I'm here to give you what I got. And prayerfully it'll help you get up off the block. They say I'm acting funny lately, that's crazy. I'm just here being a father to my newborn and husband to my old lady. Mind my biz until my biz pay me. Stay out the way, cause youngins killing grown men as of lately. I'm never scared, I just respect the fact. I'm no longer where you are, but I've been where you at. The way you feel about a snitch, I feel about a rat. This new era built different, I ain't talking cap. I relate to the hard-headed, I've been in the car headed just to spin backsliding. I am talking fact, every time I run away from God, I end up walking back. So when he tell me do something, he don't hear me talking back. Meet you where you at when I reflect on what I did too. Meet you where you at cause I relate to what I've been through. Meet you where you at, I still struggle like most men do. Meet you where you at, let's keep it real, you know I sin too. If I see you, I'ma meet you where you at, and hopefully we can find a place to chat. We can find a place to chat. Let's keep it real, I've been exactly where you at. So when we speak, it's with some mutual respect. I understand a lot of people can't relate. So when they speak, they try to put you in your place. But that ain't me, I'm here to give you what I got, and prayerfully it'll help you get up off the block.
I'ma testimonies to these trenches, speaking from experience, cause I know I really lived it. I could meet them where they at, cause I participated in it, and I know they can relate, cause I really know the feeling. So lately I've been praying for my dogs, and left the streets alone, but I've been siding with the cross. Still in these trenches, I'm just trying to lead the loss. I just hope be the bridge, fill the gap, if they ever need the cross. Cause I done lost phase where I had to get my run back. Being inside of shootouts where I had to let my gun clap. Was really in the field flocking, just to make my fun stack and glorifying it. But I done been there and done that. I know how it is when you out here feeling lost too. Know how I feel, you want revenge if someone crossed you. Know how I feel, you try to forgive, but it's hard to. But I learned to love people for who they are, cause that's what God do. Yeah.
If I see you, I'ma meet you where you at, and hopefully we can find a place to chat. We can find a place to chat. Let's keep it real, I've been exactly where you at. So when we speak, it's with some mutual respect. I understand a lot of people can't relate, so when they speak, they try to put you in your place. But that ain't me, I'm here to give you what I got, and prayerfully it'll help you get up off the block. Help you get up off the block.
So we're back again with comic relief of No More Dirty TV, and here's your host now, Fred Whitlaw, aka Minister Fred 2. All right, Kenny, let's do this real quick. You know what you're gonna have to understand is if you run and hang out with this dude, he used to be my manager when I was on the road rapping. Now he's in the studio with me. I don't know which one's funnier. come, listen, and I need, come, hey, Kitty, come here for a second. Come here for a second. We got to give them this before we give them the Friday, Saturday, Sunday thing. Listen, this right here is a funny moment. Come here, bro. Tell them about when we go to a movie.
Oh. Okay.
Sorry,
I gotta get low.
Wait a minute, you can use it too tight.
All right, so Fred and I.
Right.
I mean, we're partners, right?
We're partners all the way. Except he has a beard, I know.
Yeah. So we would go to a movie. Now, the mistake was it was an action movie.
It was what was that about? Okay, all right. Go ahead.
It was an action movie, right?
Yeah, it was, but what's the mistake?
Well, because you get it right. Anyway, the problem was don't give this man any sugar. You ain't had none today, have you?
I did. No, I did. I don't think I did.
This man cannot handle sugar. You know, some folk can't handle the alcohol. He can't handle the sugar. So if he has a little bit of sugar.
I had Mike and Ike's, bro.
I like Mike and Ike.
I do too.
Yeah. So I'm trying to enjoy the movie. And he's got this box of candy. He snuck it into the movie.
I sure did. I went to the Dollar Tree. You didn't hear that.
But throughout the movie, this dude, man, I mean, did you see that? Oh, did you see that? Right, I mean, just keet, man, just keet. Because he had sugar. So this is what I did, right? I'm a father, so I understand how to do these things.
What are you saying? Okay, go ahead, finish the joke.
So I said, hey, man, let me have some of the Mike and Ike's.
Okay.
So he passed me the box of Mike and Ike. And I just put him on the other side. I said, you ain't getting no more.
This dude took my Mike and Ike. I really wanted to go thug on him.
Had to take him, man. I had to take him.
And with that being sound, we're going to go to two videos because you don't need to hear no more jokes that come from his mouth. We're going to give you a real comedian. We got to give up. We're going to go. Let's give him some Tim Hawkins. It is called Wrong Psalms because you're in the wrong right now. And then we go.
Who's wrong right now? Y'all tell me, put in the comment section who's wrong right now.
We're going to give some Cannon and feature Derek Minor. Let's do that one. And we just be like, yo, okay, you can't hold us back. We'll be right back. It's on the pop.
Yes.
Yeah.
No more dirty.
But my testimonies are usually how I mess up, man. Remember, I was doing this show about 3 years ago, and it was this big deal. It was about this size, almost like 2,000 people. And I was doing this show, and after I did pretty good. And after the show, they took me to this room with this table, had a pen on it. I'm like, okay, what do you want me to do here? And they said, well, we're going to let some people in, and we want you to sign autographs. And I said, okay, I can do that. And they did. They opened the door, like 100 people line up at that table for my autograph. I'm like, oh, sweet. I felt pretty good about myself. The first lady in the line, she walks up to me and she goes, would you put your favorite Bible verse under your name for me? Just your name and then put your favorite Bible verse underneath. Could you do that?
I'm like, okay. Sure.
Well, my favorite Bible verse is Psalm 34, verse 8. It says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who take refuge in him. That was my favorite verse. But that night, I forgot the verse. I just blanked on it. You know how sometimes you know, like, sir, when you dress today, you know what I'm talking about? It's like your brain isn't, it's just not working. So I'm thinking, I'm like, oh, it's Psalm something. I got to pick something. And I said, oh, I'll just have to make up a verse here. So I did. I picked Psalm 38, verse 7. Just picked it out of thin air. Psalm 38, 7. Okay, I did it. Like an idiot, I did them all that way. Tim Hawkins, Psalm 38, 7. Hope you enjoyed the show. So I'm driving home that night. I'm like, oh, Lord, I hope that was a good verse. Oh, Lord, could you change the scripture if it's not, just for one night? But he did not hear my prayer. So I get home, and I look up Psalm 38, verse 7. And to my horror, it says, lo, I have a painful disease in my loins. Oh, yuck it up. Thanks for the help. What are there, a billion verses in the Bible? And I chose that one. And I signed it 100 times. And sent it out in my own little mission field. Go! Take the word! Don't forget my loin problem. Build schools and hospitals. Don't forget my loin disease. Because you know those people looked it up. You know they did. They probably made a big deal out of it. Come on here. Sit down, kid. Sit down. We're going to read this first. Turn the TV off. Get over here. Here it is. Psalm 38:7. Shh. It says life first. Shh. It says, lo, I have a painful disease. I shook his hand. I shook his hand. I shook that pervert's hand. What was I doing? I knew I... See, look at you. Some of you don't get that. Lo, I have a painful disease in my loin. Never gonna see that verse cross-stitched on a pillow.
I can't let nobody hold me back. 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 I can't let nobody hold me back.
I'ma get on my body. Aching for the cannon, gon' cock it. I was told that they had to get polished. Thought I wouldn't make it out without college. But now I'm giving that verse, don't copy. Struggle, I crawl through. Ain't no walking away from the father. God bless you, can't do it. I know who I'm called to. Ain't a slave, I know what that law do. Ball and chain, get that salt too. Freedom got me stepping like I'm doo doo. What up, Memphis 10? What they doo doo?
I can't let nobody. I can't let nobody know me back.
Rocking button downs in the bummy slacks with the Birkenstocks. Looking like the Nan Flynn is tight with the plumbers crack. No, I'm done with that. No soccer mama loud. Cameron thinking she a Thundercat. She gon' start a match. If she go to cops, we might pull up with 100 blacks. No, I can't let nobody hold me back. Keep looking at me like I only ride. You gon' hit a ceiling, yeah. You told me that. It's cause you want me under. They done show me that. And now I get it. I know even homies cap. Respect the minute I don't ask for. We can fast forward. I'm pulling the dump on you dummies right here. It's the crash course. Could've had more. They done know I've been working my mental health. It's like a task force. Got a back door when my negative thoughts get to creep. But now I got a plan for him like I'm at war. Give a scripture that get me up out of my head. I'ma add more than a tad more. My respect is the only thing that I'm not willing to ask for. I'm a home man. After surviving the sharks, you gon' watch your homeland. Better hold fast. When them wolves come around the corner, they gon' do their own dance. And that's all facts. I done turn these niggas into students. I don't need your hall pass. Get my home bag. Cannon done rose, he done resurrected through the small cracks.
Hold on.
I pray to God I can't little. Faith don't fail me, I can't settle. I'm trying to look cool. Mean machines ain't nothing when the medical bills keep coming. I'm down to my luck. Told his money on the way. I'm tired of waiting to get paid. So what am I doing? Wife at work, she don't sleep. But a couple hours every week. Fall off and keep moving. Ain't going out of my way for nobody else unless it's mandatory. Better plan accordingly. My family, faith, and future matter more than me. I mean importantly. My only competition be that little voice in my head. I'm distracted by oppositions. I don't mind pivoting. I'm switching directions. I'm tired of them judging by how we living. Got a pile of energy, bro. I don't get motivated. Round them knowing I'm tolerating. Don't know how I made it. All too real, I get uncomfortable when it's a lot of faking. Let me pilot the glizzy. I play whatever gets ahead. It's bigger than them feelings in me. I got volcanic, titanic, mountain lion energy. That's how I'm meant to be.
I can't let nobody hold me back.
Welcome back. Now you know I have a midget that works for me. No, he didn't. No, he's not. He's actually a little bit taller than me. He just was on his knees. It took him 5 minutes to get up. That's a humorous moment. That's comedy. And it's clean. So listen, let's do the Friday, Saturday thing, Kenny. So every Friday, this is what we do. In fact, every Wednesday evening and Friday evening, 7:30 p.m. Central Standard Time. No More Dirty TV. Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook, all of that. And then you get the links on TikTok as well. So make sure you subscribe to the channel. It's No More Dirty Inc. That's the YouTube channel. That's everything. Facebook channel. Everything is No More Dirty Inc. All right? Then, let's see, Saturday. Saturday. It is our talk show, our transformative talk show. It's called The Session Live. In fact, let me tell you something. We're going to have the comedian live before the show. It's going to be him and I. We're going to have just a real transparent, and that's going to be Saturday, 2 p.m., so you can get it. And then we're going to bring him back even after the show on Monday, 7:30 p.m. So Saturday, it's going to be at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. Then on Monday, before he flies out, gets up out of here, we're going to have him hang out with us for the day, and you'll get a chance to hear from him again on Monday night at 7:30 p.m. Central. So you get to hang out with him at the show on Saturday, March the 9th, 5:30 doors open, 6 p.m. Get your tickets. Listen, tonight is the night to be able to make sure you're ready for it, for the show. The show is going to be bananas. Then we got DJ Teef on the ones and twos from No More Dirty Radio Show. He going to kick it, boom, boom, boom. Special guest, throw up his picture, Andre out of Michigan. Now he's in the area. He's going to do give you some of that lovey-dovey joint, all clean. And then we're going to have some good times. Just we're going to fellowship, take pictures. We got all of that stuff. So again, that's going to take place. The show is going to be Saturday, March 9th, which is coming up tomorrow. At 6 o'clock, the show starts 5:30 p.m. And then on Sunday, you already know, you'll get the boom bat. No More Dirty Radio on G93, 5 p.m. Central Standard Time. We Up 103.1, 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. And then worldwide and around the globe with envision-radio.com. So listen, you're going to get it. And that's at 4 p.m. Eastern or 3 p.m. Central. Globally, look at your listing and you got it. So that's what we got going on. I mean, it's a whole lot. So listen, you got the show tonight. You got the live clean comedy No More Dirty series tomorrow night. And then you get to listen to all this stuff and kick it, hang out with a man on the radio show Sunday, Monday. He hang out with us and then he's going to hit the road, keep his tour going. So listen, I think what we should do, Kenny, let's give him a taste. Let's give him a taste and then we're going to do the wrap up after this. So here it is. You already know, clean national comedian, Double D. We'll be right back.
Mr. Double D. Turn.
How y'all doing? Y'all better clap loud enough. I done wore my little tight Easter suit. I'm about to pass out. Feel like I got on the body magic. I used to be a stripper though. Oh y'all, but I was a stripper from the temp service. You know they called me when somebody got hurt. I was a temp strip. I like the Planet Peanut Man, don't I? Don't be judging me. This is the silly part of the show. It's the silly part of the show right here. I'm already mad. I'm on edge. On the way here, I almost got pulled over by the cops. I don't like the cops. Police ain't no joke, because they dirty. All of them's cool, but some of them is, yeah, they so dirty. One of them about 2 months ago. This cop was so dirty, y'all. He pulled me over. He was on a motorcycle. He was so dirty, he pulled me over and took me to jail on the back of a motorcycle. I'm handcuffed and everything. I got my little helmet on. I'm trying to hold on. Like, man, slow down. So I wrap my legs around. Man, slow down. Well, slow down then. He gonna pull somebody else over and make me sit in the middle. I'm like, he take me through the drive-thru at Wendy's. I said, man, you trying to embarrass me. Take me to jail. No, I want no hamburger. Take me to jail. Everybody looking at me laughing. My baby mama see me, the last person see me, she laughing. Look at you. My baby mama, she all right, but she ain't that swift. Everybody in here know somebody, work with somebody, or related to somebody that's not that bright. But you still love him. You know what I'm about? Put your hands up. Take a look around. The one that got their hands up, that's the one they talking about. Y'all! You! One night, me and my baby mama, we was just riding, right? We just ride. We drive past this car dealership, right? We drove past this car lot. She was like, man, that club packed. Get out! Get out! That's a car lot. Get out! The same night, a car pulled right next to us, right? It was a couple. The couple's hugging and kissing each other, right? My baby mama's hitting me on my leg. See, look at that couple. See, now that's a couple that love each other. They even got a sticker on their car that symbolizes their love. Look at what the sticker say. Look. We love just us. Why we can't love just us? The way they love just us, why I can't be just us? You mean we love Jesus? Get out of the car. Get out of the car. We love just us. You going home. My homeboy, he ain't too bright neither. He ain't that bright. My homeboy is dumb as a brick. He was trying to give me direction. True story. He was trying to give me direction to get to his house, right? He said, you're going to get on the freeway. You're going to take the freeway to downtown. You're going to go downtown. You're going to go underneath the bypass. First exit. Gonna be Milk Drive. Get off and make a right on Milk Drive, and you're gonna make a left. Get off on Milk Drive. All right, where's Milk Drive? Milk Drive! You mean Martin Luther King Drive? You mean Tim, I done drove around 2 hours asking everybody what Milk Drive is? I'm hanging out the one, excuse me, there on Milk Drive. Yes, can you tell me where Milk Drive is? Milk! Yes, milk! M-I-L-K, milk. I talk to women way smarter than men. Oh, yeah. Women cheat, men cheat. But trust me, women more smoother than men. Can't catch a woman cheat. Women 10 steps ahead of the game. Watch all the women laugh when I say this. Watch all the women laugh when I say this. A woman so smooth, she can introduce you to a dude she messing with, you ain't know. And man, we so stupid, we shaking his hand, how you doing? I'm comedian DeGarry Young Turner, Double D, thank y'all. Yeah. Thank y'all.
There we go again. I don't know why we do this, but keep it. Welcome back to myself. Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. Welcome back. I have a vocal. So anyway, listen, here's how we're going to wrap this thing up. We're going to give you some boom bap. I think let's do D1. I hadn't heard from him in a minute. So we got D1, 1K Few, and Ha Gazelle. In fact, Ha Gazelle and 1K Few, they're actually touring the Pray for Atlanta tour right now. Shout out to Reach Records. So let's do that song, and then let's go out again with one more, Kenny. Let's do another one from the National Clean comedian, Double D, who will be with us tomorrow. So listen, again, I want to say thank you for taking the time to tune in. Be sure to go and get a ticket. Now listen, here's the beautiful thing about this clean comedy show. When you get your ticket, whether it's a regular ticket at $30, or if you get the VIP up to the front, all that good stuff, $45, here's what's going to happen. You're not only going to have a great time, you're going to get up close, get some pictures and all that kind of cool stuff, but the proceeds, every dollar, is going to help us support the Greatness Project. And it's moving kids from detention, from the negative situations, to a place where they understand their purpose and where they know that they are great. And when you know you're great, you don't have a reason to do things that cause hurt, harm to you and others. So listen, this, and I'll say this, I had two people call, a couple companies say, hey, we can't come, but can we sponsor? You sure can. Go to the website. Kenny got it on the bottom. www.nmdinc.org. Support. Just say, go in and click it. You say, I want to get 4 tickets. And then send us an email. If you put in the, it has the little caption, you can put in there. I want to donate these for some kids. So donate it for some people. Giveaways for the station. Shout out to WJOU. Shout out to Alabama A&M JB. Shout out to the Chocolate Rocket City. Shout out to them for making this thing happen. and making sure that we were able to get this information out. And to all the other anonymous supporters, thank you so much. So again, I just want you to know we're going to take you out with some 1K fuel. Let me pray for you. I hope to see you tomorrow. Listen, you got DJ Teef on the ones and twos. You got the opening act, man, Andre. He's dope. Got a smooth R&B, R&P vibe. And then National Clean Comedian doing a full hour and a 15, hour and 30 minute set. So you're going to have a full 2 hour show. And every dollar is going to support our initiative. And again, we say thank you, thank you, thank you. So let me pray and we'll let you get out with my man. You already know. God, we want to say thank you. Thank you for comedy. Thank you for humor. Thank you for the joy that comes. Thank you for allowing us not get stuck in our bones dry. And so I pray that you'll be with everyone listening and tuned in today. In the name of He who blesses us, He who knows us, and He who cares. In the name of Yahshua the Christ, who is Jesus of the Bible. Amen. Hey, this is your boy, Minister Fred 2. I'm out. You already know, like, gotta go. Okay, peace. Enjoy the movie. No, I'm sorry. Enjoy the show. There you go again. Tatty. That's a wrap. And this chair is kind of wiggle. Oh, my goodness. Hold up. Hey, man, cut that camera. Cut the camera, brother.
Go to the face. Cause the episode is not the face. Cause the episode is not the face. The face. The face. Go to the face. Cause the episode is not the face. Cause the episode is not the face. The face. The face.
We'll get it, Jack. On time. Well, now we know how excited I got. I got too excited, man. Oh, Lord have mercy.
Yeah. What time in here? Like 12, 21. Just took down to Minnesota, but ain't nothing small about this Posco. When I thought it was gonna be over, I told my mama that I won't stop. I told some problems at the bottom, and now I'm solving them up top. Made a lot of my partners change instead of watching them on cost. I came a long way from trying to rob the candy lady. Sorry, Miss Jack. I'm sorry. I was working hard for them snacks. Every time I got with my dogs, it was shaggy. Now I'm finally getting no sleep without trying to find a plug for them addies. I ain't wanna keep dodging bullets, trying to put a hole in one with no caddy. 4 years is what they gave little Polo, sadly. I don't know why he robbed them four, but he taking it like a soldier if you ask me. Know. Only reason he's still sitting in there is cause they sang on him like Razzie. That's why. But it's crazy how he kept it too silent while the church folks backstabbed. They'll judge you just for walking on the grass too fast, kinda like Stanley. But they don't wanna see all the gangsters come and get saved, cause they too manly. Why you sitting there looking like a deer stuck in them headlights? What you bandy? What? That's why I keep the armor of God around me while I'm in the water like Sandy.
I come from the swamp, so sometimes I act like an ogre. And I guarantee when that sun go down, she gon' change like Fiona. Had to learn how to hide my pain, been wearing masks before the Rona. Tryna hop up in that water, you gon' find out that you Jonah. I come in beating on my chest, I thought I told ya, I'm a soldier. I thought that drugs were none the pain, but it just made me colder. I guess my body temperature the same as all their shoulders. I thought I knew it all when I was young, but I got older.
Gotta know your name, your background, and your story before we meet. If I don't know where your mama stay, can't let you know where I sleep. When my gut told me don't trust old girl, I should've took heed. She friendly with too many dudes, and that ain't what I need. Was a trench baby, now I got trust fund money for my little seeds. My grandma died last year, but I still hear her voice in my sleep. When I signed my deal, I bought 3 cars and gave them to my partners. Kept riding around in my hoopty, man, I love being modest. Man, I love being godly. Yeah. I'm a rebel, plus I'm rowdy. In my section, they be catching smurder charges like a hobby. And I be going through hella storms, but handle them like Kyrie Irving, cause I'm swerving past them even when they foul me. We the big three, few and I hiding beside me. All my circles linked together, kinda like an Audi. Only way that I survived the trenches, God allowed me. That's why I say his name on every song and do it proud.
This is me and all my brothers, me and all my brothers, me and all my brothers. Same father, different mothers. I got love for all my brothers. Through the mud, hair, tell me. We the same when we in public. We ain't chained for no money, they're my brothers. Sorry that they call you, they're my brothers. All I know is hustle through the struggle with my brothers. Keep the thing on shuffle, cause you never know it's coming. Even when my life was bumming, they ain't jumping on my brothers. My brothers, my brothers, my brothers, my brothers, my brothers.
From Atlanta, Georgia, you've seen him on BET Comic View. Give it to my man, Double D.
Oh, y'all can keep clapping. I know y'all ain't never seen me no way. I ain't never seen y'all either. So how we doing? Trying to judge me already. So God is good. Hey, y'all better clap, man. I done spent my whole day at Burger and Coke Factory trying to buy that little tight suit. Boy, y'all don't clap. Man, in a tight suit I got on. Lord Jesus. I can't hardly move. I'm also from Nigeria. How y'all good, y'all doing today? Okay, how you playing? I'm from Atlanta. Look, this is the silly part of the show. I'm gonna let y'all know. I haven't seen my dad in over 17 years, man. For real. My mama said he dark skinned, he wear glasses. And he live in Atlanta. I said, that's all the information? I think I found my daddy. Mama, we got him. We got him, mama. We got him. He had world changes. He had world changes. He with another family. Life. Look, for real, my real dad is 64 years old. This is true. 64 years old. This, I promise you, this, it just happened. He just caught cheating at 64 years old. Who get caught cheating at 64? Next door. He climbing out of the windows backwards at 64 years old. His wife standing right behind him. He gonna call me, you know, to help him move. Hey, man, can you help me move? Ursula, man, she tripping. You know, he's 64, Ursula. She gonna put me out. She want me to move all my stuff out. I said, okay, Dad, I'm come help you. So, right, I go get the biggest U-Haul I can find, right, to help my daddy move, the big one. I pull up to his house. He come out the house with one Kroger bag full of clothes. I said, you mean to tell me we ain't been together? Y'all been together 17 years and your whole lifeline is in that one little bag? He gonna go to the back of the truck and lift the door up and put the bag in the back. I said, you can put that in the front seat in your lap. Y'all, look, I just turned 40. Got a newborn, y'all. Show me some love. A newborn baby. Oh, Lord, y'all pray for me. 40 years old, what am I thinking about? And my wife said, I want another one. I said, oh, no, the devil is a lie. I tie my own tubes. That's it right there. Oh, no. The devil is a lie. Man, that means I'm going to be 50 with a 10-year-old. Ah! Oh! I pray to God she don't want to be a cheerleader. I pray she don't want to be a cheerleader because I'm going to be so embarrassed. Show up at cheerleader practice with wingtips and jogging pants. The kids gonna be laughing. Heck, when your granddaddy, look, I'm the daddy. My uncle called me, right? He heard the good news. My uncle's 65. He got them diabetic shoes. You gotta plug them to the wall and charge them up. He got them prepaid shoes. He had 2 minutes left. So he'll call me, right? He said, look, heard the good news, man. Congratulations. Heard she got a newborn. I said, yes. He said, you know what that mean, right? I said, what? He said, that mean you got to get yourself together. You got to go to the doctor. Go get your physical so you'll be around for your baby. I said, you're right. He said, I just went and got my prostate checked about 2 weeks ago. I'm like, whew, congratulations. He said, you got your check? I said, yeah, I did mine online. that for real? He had a big ring on too. I said, that was a lie. Oh. I'm silly, y'all. I said, Lord, have fun, man. God is good. Been married 4 years going on, and we've been together 7 years. Y'all show me some love. Marriage. Marriage ain't no joke, but it's a beautiful thing. You got to be married to the right person. God got to send you your wife or your husband. That's why a lot of marriages don't work. Compromising. Watch this right here. What's the number one cause of divorce? What's the number one cause of divorce? No, marriage is the number. Okay. I'm just playing. These jokes. Y'all like that one. Marriage is a lot of stress. Watch this. I bet you every married man in here got a bald spot in his head. Look. From stress. Look at him. He got a bald head with a bald spot. You see that? That's stress right there. He's trying to hide it. I love you, Dad. I need everybody right now. If you got a touchscreen phone, hold them up. If you have a touchscreen phone, hold them up. If you have a phone with a flip on it, we're going to put you out. You should have not have a flip on your phone. You should not have a flip on your phone in 2013 going into 14. Listen to me very carefully. So y'all, you so-called wannabe players, you can't be a player with these phones. Oh, yes. These phones are too sensitive. Oh, yes. Everybody in here have called somebody by mistake and didn't even know it. You know how many times I called my wife by mistake? I looked down on the phone. She been on the phone 4 hours. Because a woman will not hang up. A woman will sit on that phone till tomorrow. Hoping you'll say something. Say something.